And you feel a good and sweet spirit just
Amen.
Hovering around.
Amen.
Sure feels good, don't
it?
That might have been what y'all had in here last night. It's sure here tonight. And it's here for me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You come looking for something?
Amen.
Long something?
Lord.
Are you going to get it?
Amen.
Amen. The victory is ours. Hallelujah. How many have requests you'd like to make known about them today? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight, Lord, for the many wonderful blessings. And Lord, we thank you for calling our name, dear Lord, and setting us here at your table at this hour, Lord, to eat of that food that you prepared for us. Lord, we can't thank you enough for us tonight, dear Lord. God, for giving us the thunder in our presence, Lord, to lead us and guide us and give us that word, Lord, that you give for your people. You laid up for your people for this hour, Lord. We thank you for it. God, we pray that you'll bless each one now, Lord. Give them strength, Lord, to stand. God, you know the desire and the need of every heart tonight, Lord. We pray that everything be done in your perfect will and your glory, that your will be done in behalf of each one, Lord. God, we pray that you'll stand with your servant, Lord. Bless him as he comes tonight. We thank you for him, Lord. We thank you for how he stands on your word. God, to lead us and guide us in this hour, Lord. God, we pray you, my Lord. We pray, Lord, that you'll bless the service now. Take everything into your hands, Lord, and let it be in your perfect will. In Jesus' name.
There's going to be a we'll be right back.
everybody say amen.
Amen.
When we sing that, I hope we realize what we're here. And all we have to do is just believe it. I read several things. I think I did last night. I preached several things. I don't remember how much I read. I start reading a little bit, just keep on talking. But you just watch the news and watch your preachers, and they just think about what we got here. How many believes it's absolutely the Word of God? And it don't matter what the rest of the world says at all. One of the preachers I was listening to yesterday said, there is some secrets that's never been preached. And he said, I would like to know where the man is at that can preach some of these.
Amen.
So when they're supposed to come, I'd like to hear them.
Amen.
Can I tell you they're fixing to?
Amen.
You believe they're going to hear them in a little while? Everything they're asking for, it's coming. But out of all that's happening now, I'm just going to tell you how it is. When I'm studying, I can whip anybody. When I'm here and it gets all over me, I can whip anybody. Then when I sit down sometimes and just get to thinking about it, it scares me. That's the human part.
Lord,
to know what's got to be done. Somebody's going to do it.
Amen.
God's word is unspoken that somebody's going to do what I'm preaching to you. Do you believe it? Do you believe every word we hear that is in here?
Amen.
It has to be fulfilled.
Amen.
Somebody's going to do it.
Amen.
Well, I don't think you're a bunch of idiots sitting here.
Amen.
I think you believe what you're here. What are these thinking that's going to do what I'm preaching about?
Yeah.
They're on the earth right now. Yeah. Time is running out.
Yeah.
And there's somebody, and I'm going to open the book in a minute and read it to you. Somebody has got to do it.
Yeah.
And I'll promise you, it'll be God, which is the Word, in a man.
Amen.
It will not be the man that will get any credit for it.
Amen.
Only the God.
Amen.
Only the Word. As I told you last night, this was already written that these sons are going to do this before I was ever born.
Amen.
I had nothing to do with it. Do you believe it was already in the plan of God that you'd be sitting here to hear this?
Amen.
Before you was ever born, He knew who would be here. Work. And I stop sometimes when the anointing's on and things are said. I get just as excited as you do. But I know it's going to happen.
Amen.
But then I stop and say, how's it going to be? Little on me. So you ain't all that little compared to all that's out here. And you're stopping things. How many around believe what we?
Amen.
What are they going to think when this hits the airway and it's going to hit?
Amen.
What are they going to think? You know the first thing they're going to
think? Who does he think he is?
Bless the Lord.
But do you know what the good part is this time? How many know what the good part is?
God's
going to
back it up.
He's going to prove to the people we're as right as that.
Amen.
That's right. If I told you last night, I'd get more sick every time I turned the news on. I'm getting more sick of this place.
Amen.
I'm not talking about Martinville. I'm talking about this earth that we live on. I'm getting sick of it.
Amen.
Well, if God's in you, do you believe he's sick of it?
Amen.
Then somebody's got to do something about it.
Amen.
And the prophet made it so plain. And we've heard these things over and over. But now, it's so much plainer.
Amen.
When the prophet said, the coming of the Lord and the thunders are mixed together.
Amen.
Connected together.
Amen.
You can't separate.
Amen.
He didn't make a mistake when he said
it. Amen.
Amen.
So these secrets that people are wondering about, and all they got to do is open the Bible and read it. But I'm going to show you in a minute and read from it. And these books, we've read them over and over right now. They mean more to me than they ever did.
Amen.
Because all this that we've been hearing is us now.
Amen.
Do you believe that? Are you becoming what we've been hearing here? Which is the word? Are you becoming that?
Amen.
I hope you are, because we've got to be here.
Amen.
And I'm going to tell you, in just a little while.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I read it to you last night in this book that I got laying out here. When the seven angels were given the trumpets, the first thing happened. Four angels. He said, hold. Tell them to hold the wind, which is the war. Until I have sealed 144,000. Then you go over a few more paragraphs to that sixth angel sounded, and that's already took place. That sixth trumpet's already happened. And he didn't say hold them any longer. What did he say? Turn them loose. Loose the four angels. That's been holding the wind. Holding the war. Turn them loose. What do you think's been going on out here in the last little while? Do you see it? Do you see the word? And I read it to you and proved it to you that this sixth trumpet has done that. Because between the sixth prophet and the seventh one, which is Moses and Elijah, between that, the Gentiles are to receive a messenger. Have we received that messenger?
Amen.
To turn the hearts back to the original word again. In between the sixth and the seventh. So they had been turned loose. And I'm going to fall back here in a minute and make it even more plain. And when you see this, like you're supposed to, and see that these six trumpets have already took place, when you see that six seals are behind us, and I want to tell you in the name of the Lord, the seventh one is about over.
Amen.
Not fixing to start, but it's just about over with.
Amen.
And I've been told in this book that even on this seventh seal, and we know that God don't have but seven men. I believe with all my you. Is what's going to meet the people. And you're talking about somebody with a backbone.
Amen.
Ain't it good to know you got the Word of God for your backbone?
Amen.
I'm not saying you're dependent on any denomination to back you up. This is a big war. This is a big battle that we're heading into. I don't have a denomination to have.
Amen.
Not one, but I got the whole host of heaven. More free to preach this year than I ever have been. And the reason is, this is the year. There won't be another one. Oh, we're going to be here 1,000, but there won't be another one come in like this one. Last Sunday, a week ago, when the remaining are gathering in. and just for a little pleasure, get up and walk out.
Yeah.
You ain't even going to have time to enjoy it. It's going down. Are you sick of women taking over? You might work in behind me on it. Are you sick of hearing all this filthy language every time somebody gets around you? Are you sick of all this trash that Savior on the earth? So when I preach these things, when I read them to you here, in a little bit, ain't you glad the prophet said, seven thunders, oh my, the complete.
Amen.
If he said the seven thunders,
will cap the pyramid.
That'll be the end of it. Well, if you believe them, when they tell you to get ready,
yeah!
and the prophet said they were naked.
That's right.
Amen.
Right. And don't miss this. He broke down. Started crying.
He wasn't dreaming this. He was looking at it.
Amen.
And he said, here they was, dancing to rock and roll music.
Amen.
You know what it's all? Bob heard women.
Painted face Jezebel.
Amen.
Dancing to the beat of rock and roll.
Amen.
Lord.
He said, I screamed. I cried. Is that the best I could do? Is that all I could get for you, Lord?
He said they went on out of sight.
Yeah.
And about the time they got out of sight, I heard the sweetest sound I ever heard before. Here we come. And he said, I want for you to come to real true
bride.
The same bride that was in the beginning is at the end.
Amen.
And here they come, listen to this, marching right in step with everyone.
Amen.
But as he saw the preview of the bride, he said, I watched them march.
And some of them would step out.
This
was the bride.
And what did he scream? Get back in line with that.
Yeah.
He done gone. Did he raise somebody here?
Yeah.
And say, now you say what I say.
Yeah.
You raise somebody alive. Come, get back in line with that one.
Yeah.
You're the bride.
Yeah.
And he won't lose one of you. Be getting more peace of mind than ever.
Yeah.
You believe God, don't you?
Yeah.
Yes,
say, I'm praying and word myself today. I've been praying that this will make it.
Bless the Lord.
If they're his, they'll be that.
Yeah.
If they ain't, they can't get that.
Yeah.
So all the Father's giving is coming to it.
Yeah.
Every one of my brothers are going. Well, you didn't have no sister. I got them sitting all over this field right here. Every one of my brothers and sisters will be right there with me. Oh, we got the same Father.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. And seen the vision of the preview of the bride in the church, as I told it, just as you showed me. And here we are. It may be later than we think.
Amen.
Somebody asked the prophet, said, when the seventh seal comes open,
will it be over? He said, I hope not.
Well, who would?
Amen. He didn't say, no, it won't be over. He said, I hope not. But when the seventh seal come open, that's the coming of the Lord.
That's right.
How many believe he's the Word? How many believe he's still right here with his bride?
Thank you.
I want to turn back here. And some of these things I hit last night. And we're talking about in Revelation, the ninth chapter. And see all these pages. I don't know why I do this to myself. But the whole world, every religious preacher that I hear that calls herself a Christian, this is what they're looking for. And if I could turn to the page right here. They're saying,
I think this is
the year that the rapture will take place. To show you how far behind they are, this is the year it will end.
That's right.
there's laying in. The dirt's going to be rolled back. People are going to be running to the graveyard. Some's going to be driving down in a car, and all of a sudden, if the husband was driving and he was one of them, and the wife wants you to look over and ain't nobody driving the car. And you'll be, let me just put it to you like I said, listening to your radio. This is what this is. And all of a sudden, you don't hear nobody. The fella that's in the radio station, taking care of it,
it's gone. And they got some coming out of cars. Some about this high in the air. Some way up in the air.
And all of them thinks this is going to happen this year. But the prophet said, remember the vision of the other day, the preview of it. Said, I seen that dirty, filthy thing come up called the church and that little bride of every nation. And said, walking before the Lord, you notice, said there'll be a time sometime when they'll say, well, I thought the church was to go before the persecution. I thought there was going to be a rapture. It's already passed and you do it not.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me ask you,
is that going to happen?
Amen. Amen.
Is that God's word that this will happen?
Amen.
Is the same word that we hear that rise is saying,
and
healing campaigns in your name? Look at the devils I cast out in your name!
Amen.
He'll say, depart from me.
He ain't gonna say, I don't know you.
Never.
I never knew you.
Amen.
You believe he knows you?
Amen.
He never knew that.
Right. Out of all the jumping up and down,
Amen.
All the filth on the platform,
Amen.
All the impersonators which ain't doing nothing but blasphemy.
Amen.
That's the truth.
I saw this same preacher this afternoon that I tell you about that I watch every Sunday. Some of you may have seen him. And he called a colored man and woman up. He held the mic up and asked the woman, do you know him? She said, yes. Who is it? That's my brother. Stupid question, look, said, do you know her? Wouldn't that be his sister? And he stood there and talked. And he cannot just pray for what they want and go. He says, I'm seeing a vision. This is calm and unconcerned. He said, you've been hurt, somebody stole your coat today. Real pretty coat. Football coat. Had letters on. Said, you wondering right now where that coat's at. Okay, look. He said, I'm going to go a step further and tell you where your coat's at. One of your friends still got it. Said, his name starts with a C. Said, I can't. Figure out what the name is, but I thought he was seeing a vision.
Amen.
That's right.
He said, the name starts with a C, could be Carl. Nobody's name. He named all seven more. Well, anyhow, his name starts with a C. And he said, before I lay my hands on you, and all this is going to be took care of, You have a kidney problem. Were you aware of that? Well, you are not. These people can walk up and just have a headache before they leave. They're naked. Didn't even know it. Think about it. Had no idea if he had kidney problems.
Impersonate. Blasphemy. An old man walked up in front of him.
Had hearing aid. He said, take it out. The old man took it out. Real old stuff. He said, God's going to heal your hearing completely. Wait a minute. Did I pray for you before? Yeah. Well, you got healed. Yeah. You let the devil steal it, didn't you? He fooled that old man too much. Took the hearing aid. Said, now put this thing away. He slapped him like scared him to death. Screamed out. What would you do if somebody standing in front of you and all of a sudden, help! Oh, man, I got real big. Whoa, I hear you now. How could he not hear? He could be damned to hear that.
And I watched that. I said, look at this. Nothing but a guinea.
Then before he got off,
he said, I won't.
I said, how many? I want 10,000 people to write me. God told him this number and send him $1,000 each. How much would that be? He said, you say, oh, that's going to be a lot of money.
Rod Parsley needs 2 point something million.
I mean, it's all that. One man, God laid it on him. One man gave him half of it. And he said, I know God's speaking to somebody. And the reason we got to have it, all our equipment, we're going to have to replace it. We're about wore it out.
Benny Hinn, I forget how many million it is he needs.
I could make a suggestion to him. How much did you pay for the jet?
Amen. That's right.
Sell it.
That's right.
And I bet you could get a few million.
Amen. That's right.
And this fleet of cars he's got.
Amen.
Do you see where they have went with this? Did the prophet scream out that same spirit over money is on the preachers today? They can't preach to you unless they're hot. Where are we at? But all these fellows that are doing this, now, as you see, when I get by myself and I see this, I say, oh, my goodness. Look at these men. But then when he gets a hold of me, and it kept me the other day, I was reading the prophet, said, look at him. Elijah pulled fire right out of heaven. Stop the heaven that it wouldn't rain. And then call for rain.
And it came.
Amen.
Everything you ever see come to pass.
Amen.
God was with it.
Amen.
Took how many prophets of Baal? Killed every one of them?
Amen.
Said then when the anointing went on it, one woman.
Amen.
He took off running.
Amen.
But when he did, that was the prophet said that was a human heart. But when he did, God sent an angel. Wake him up and feed him. Let him go back to sleep. He still wasn't going to starve.
Amen.
Amen.
That was the human part of it. When I look out here, sometimes I get like that.
And I know what's going to happen, and you know what's going to happen. I know what's going to happen this year, and you know what's going to happen. And I ask myself, why do you preach these things? I don't have a choice. Say, nobody!
If he didn't have a hold of me, then I'd stand here and say what I said the last few nights. I'd have never come out here and said, you won't turn a calendar. But then I go back and open the book, and the prophet said, they sent the doctors that's going to be here. And this battle has got to take place. And the doctor will make it happen. How are you going to make it happen? They'll have to lose. And it's only a small group. Now I want you to listen real close. What did they say there? It's already happened. The seventh trumpet is to Israel, the seventh seal to the bride.
Amen.
And we find under that the seventh seal, that when these souls that were under the altar received robes, they were given. Not that they earned them, because they were in the dispensation when God was dealing with grace with the Gentiles, not Jews. Now listen to this. And when Hitler and them persecuted the Jews, then the things they done, Stalin, Hitler, and all those dictators raised up. All these what? Dictators. Under that same age that there has been in Germany and all the other nations, Jews have scattered throughout the land. But there has raised in the last 20 years a bitter persecution against the Jews. Said, I've been out there. At the old places where they burnt their bodies, cremated, used their ashes to fertilize the ground. Children and women and everything, they tried to deny.
Have you seen that in news in the last little while? Someone said, that never did happen.
It did happen. Said, so take them right out and show them what was done. It's been a regular persecution against Israel, because it's been the time calling him now back to the atonement. And notice, making ready the people how perfect the seventh trumpet and the seventh seal is, perfectly together. Then he goes into Revelation 9:13, and he mentions these 200,000 horses. And every preacher out there says these are natural.
That there's going to be, they even know where the battle is going to take place, because they found a place where
they can get this man. And what did the prophets say? Let me read it to you. They wasn't natural horses. You know what they were? Spiritual devils, chargers, that had been bound. But remember, on that sixth seal, it's already happened. He turned loose. Now listen what happened. Notice what happened under the sixth trumpet. They were turned loose on the Jews. Supernatural devils, nearly 2,000 years then loosed by Stalin, Hitler upon the Jews.
Has that sixth seal took place?
Now, do you believe that these powers that I just read to you about are riding as hard as they can go? How far do they ride? All the way into perdition. They don't stop.
But they're going to meet somebody here.
Amen.
That's what I'm trying to get in your head. They're going to run into somebody.
Amen.
Right. In that group. Maybe I can turn over here and read it. If I can get this away. And while they're right, making themselves rich, supernatural devils unseen to die.
But you can see everything they're doing.
That's right.
While they're riding. And when I read this,
remember this here.
Amen.
They won't ride no more after this.
Amen.
It's going to be 1,000 years, there won't be one of them powers to ride.
Amen.
Not a one of them. Because they won't run into a group of people.
Amen.
I'm making this as plain as I know how.
Because all of it's going to happen in the next few months.
Maybe 12 months in a year. This is going to happen. Excited because you believe me. What I'm saying, you know it's gonna happen. I read a book here of the prophet a few nights back. The prophet said, them thunders
will make themselves
known to the bride.
Amen.
How? But what they're preaching.
Amen.
Lord.
But before long, the whole world. Do you believe that?
Amen.
Everything I hear is going to know who that same man is. This is God's plan. And his plan ain't going to fail. Are you glad you're on this side?
Amen.
There's two sides here now. That side and this side. I'm glad I'm on this side.
Amen.
It don't matter if it's a few hours. They're right,
making themselves ready to stomp out everything that don't agree with it.
Amen.
But there's another group being made ready. And this is the way I'm going to preach until we get in.
Into what? Making ourselves ready, being made ready. Another group. Altogether different than now.
Amen.
Being made ready from Revelation 19. Catch this now. And she, the bride, comes not exactly up on horses, but the Bible says they were on black horses.
So the bride, don't miss it, people. The bride is on white horses.
And here comes us. Thousands and thousands
of power.
Spiritual demons, devils, tigers.
But here comes that bride.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I love you.
The prophet said she's going to be liberated.
That's right.
Yes, here. Something like this now. She's going to be liberated this year.
Amen.
She's coming back. And don't miss this. And those two meet one another on the battleground. Book the other night and read to you. And the prophet said again, while these are riding as hard as they can, turn these people on see.
But while they're riding,
he said there's another group that's getting ready.
Amen. Yeah. That's right.
And he said, these seven thunders had it.
Amen.
Now, do you believe that?
Amen.
Don't it seem kind of odd? Out of this whole world with all these devils,
I hear God just takes seven men.
Amen.
You say, now go do it?
Amen.
Well, let me ask you this. Will they do it?
Amen.
What did he tell you? A little man named David. Standing out in the field with a jawbone in his hand that had dried up. The prophet said, you could hit it over a rock, it would bust to pieces. And 1,000 Philistines coming at it. With helmets on an inch thick.
Bless him, Lord.
Swords in their hands. Don't that look odd?
Amen.
But he led into 1,000 of
them.
He took that old jawbone that would fly to pieces, caved a helmet in that was an inch thick. I'm showing you what he's fixing to do. And killed a man that was under him.
Amen.
Say a thousand of them.
Chop it up and take
it. Watch some more than that. Sit down. Hadn't even got tired yet. All he had was a jawbone.
Right.
But he had Almighty God standing behind him. That same God is in seven men today.
Amen.
That's going to stand by you with the word of God.
Amen.
And you know what they got? They got a sword.
Amen.
You know what it's going to be? Not in the hand. The mind.
Amen.
And everything they say
Amen.
Is going to happen.
Amen.
Why? It's the word of God coming from the mouth of God.
Amen.
And God always uses the man
Amen.
To do the job.
Amen.
I want
to ask you a question. And if you don't believe it,
bless you, Lord.
Don't raise your hand. Do we know one of them?
Amen.
I'm dead serious, right?
Praise God.
You know what I'm like now? When I step outside and people come in and say,
it's getting wild and we want to leave.
Amen.
Now you're getting somewhere.
Amen.
Instead of all me glad he's done until I get out of here,
you ought to be wanting to get every bitch you get a hold of. That's going to usher that bride.
Amen.
Amen.
you walk out of here. I want you walking it when you arrive down the road. I want to see you alive. When you go by and see the film you do right down the road, I want to see that by tomorrow. When you see the sick man on the bed, I want to see this by tomorrow. I forget the name of the airport.
Miami.
That's where this hold up. That was the port that they was talking about. But all week, well, for the last day, some of the people that works for the airline,
you probably seen it. Some we've never seen nothing like this before in our life. But there was something up there.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
And they're trying to hold it down. They don't want to look into it. But the prophets, they don't know what they are.
That's right.
Amen. But they're here for a reason. I don't know.
But I promise you it's coming.
Amen.
Going the wrong way.
Bless you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Bless you, Lord.
Alice.
Tell him you love me. I can sing a song and I've been in the back of my mind all day. When to redeem or gathering in. Wash like snow. Free from all sin. I'm going to shout, and I'm going to sing.
Amen.
When they're redeemed, I gather in me. What are we going to do this year, Brother Elwood? What's he going to redeem us about? Anything that's redeemed is something that's been lost.
Amen.
And then it's been bought back again.
Amen. We lost something in the Garden of Eden.
Amen. Amen.
What did we have in the beginning? Eternal life.
Amen.
We was heirs of the world. We had life. We never had to die.
No more after this year.
Amen.
I told you I can preach it now. We never had any worries. You ought to have been running all over the place. Somebody's lusting about it. No stoop shoulder. No cry. We have jurisdiction over all of the earth. No more women preachers. No more women leaders. No more fear. No more tribes. They bought their last year in. But ours is just beginning. This is our last year. But this is the beginning. We got a thousand years here. One kingdom that's going to remain. Ain't no fire can burn it. No water can hurt it. It's going to remain here. How many lives this earth that God put you on? You just hang the dread and say blood on it. But we ought to take it back. It belongs to me. It belongs to you. There it is, no wind blowing. If you didn't want the wind to blow,
peace be still.
Yeah.
If you don't like the tree here, move over here.
Amen.
But if you're going to do that, cancer don't stand a chance.
That's right.
And it don't stand a chance.
Amen.
I said something a while ago. It's lining right up, Brother Farmer. I done told you this year, you're starting in.
Amen.
But before we can be changed,
I got to see Brother Brian.
Amen.
I got to see my dad. I got to see all my loved ones that come right here. Then we're all going to be changed together.
Amen.
Right now, your faith higher and higher because you know this is your year. There ain't a doubt in your mind. I done spoke it and you know it was God. But then 40 days, you will never suffer again. You will never have another day. You will never have a life again. I will do it in the name of the Lord. Sometimes again, I will do it.
Oh, as we drop the end of the year, I will shout.